I saw a man coming out of my son's closet. He had a bandana over his face.
November 2015, 35-year-old Katie McConnell is stunned to learn that a man has broken into her home in Richland County and is holding her at gunpoint. Sensing that her two small children are terrified, McConnell decides to pretend that the intruder is part of a game.
Said, oh my gosh, this is going to be so fun. I was like, this is going to be a super fun Halloween game, and when it's all over, you're going to get a big prize.
The gunman, later identified as 18-year-old Taylor Chrisman, does not speak, but gives McConnell a series of notes that reveal the reason for the break-in.
And it said, you know, if you don't do what I say, I will kill you and your family.
It turns out that Taylor Chrisman and his partner in crime, 23-year-old Chris Hill, targeted the family because Katie McConnell's husband is the manager of the key bank in nearby Ontario. And the suspects intend to hold the family hostage and force Brian McConnell to withdraw a large amount of cash from the bank.
I was just in shock. I couldn't believe that this was happening to me in Galion, Ohio. Like, just, it was like an extreme terror and out-of-body experience.
I walked in the door and I saw someone in a mask, a bandana, stepping back, and I thought it was a Halloween prank or something at first.
Brian McConnell says when he realized that his wife and children were being held hostage, he decided he would do whatever he could to protect them. McConnell says he convinced Taylor Chrisman to allow his wife and kids to go to another part of the house and tried to convince Chrisman that his scheme to force McConnell to take his co-workers as hostages the next morning would not work.
Started trying to talk him out of it, trying to explain that people don't get away with this kind of thing. You almost always get caught or killed. And, you know, he said, if I die, I die.
Taylor Chrisman allowed Brian McConnell to go to the bank alone the next morning before it opened and return to the home with all of the cash from the vault. Then as Chrisman began counting the money on the family's couch, McConnell decided to go for his gun.
He yelled no and attacked me. We had a scuffle. Went through a couple of rooms until I finally fought him off of me and was holding the gun on him.
McConnell says he thought about shooting Chrisman or calling the police, but fearing that his accomplices would then harm his family or his co-workers and their families, McConnell allowed Chrisman to leave really unharmed with the duffel bag full of cash from the bank. I mean, Brian McConnell then called the police.
Someone just robbed me. They took my kids hostage. They're heading west on Millsboro West Road.
Because of the unusual nature of the crime, some members of law enforcement were initially suspicious that the McConnells somehow had something to do with it, that it was a so-called inside job. But the couple was quickly cleared when they each took and passed a polygraph test.
Still, Katie and Brian McConnell say skepticism about their story persisted after some of the details were made public.
We were trashed on social media. Brian's reputation was smeared.
The McConnells were relieved when Taylor Chrisman and Chris Hill were arrested a month later. But they were angry when they learned that Hill, a customer at the bank, had hatched the hostage and robbery plan after Brian McConnell helped him with a problem he was having as the result of a fraud case. The McConnells were incensed when they learned that Hill's lover, 42-year-old Sarah Garrett, who was a juvenile court employee, used a law enforcement computer to give Hill and Chrisman the McConnells' home address.
It's despicable what she did. She knew that no good was going to come of it, regardless if she knew that there were going to be hostages taken or a bank was going to be robbed or anything.
Brian and Katie McConnell are now being treated for post-traumatic stress disorder. Brian is no longer able to work at the bank in Ontario, and as a result of issues that have arisen since their terrifying ordeal, the couple has decided to get a divorce.
Made us drift apart, and I think sometimes these things can either bring you together or they can tear you apart. And unfortunately, that's what happened for us.